musicals. They can make us laugh and cry, inspire some with dreams and others in romance. This is the topic of this essay, and I hate them. I mean, what is the point of jumping into a musical number? Cheesy music and everyone just acts like this is a normal occurrence. I hate all of them, except La La Land. But why? The story follows two performers in LA, Mia and Seb, who fall in love and start to experience relational turbulence when they each start to progress in their careers. As the characters find success, their romance also develops. All these attributes lead to this film being in line with other musicals. Even the reflexivity of each of the characters' artistic pursuits in the interludes screams classic Hollywood. So what's different? My answer is found in how this film uses its musical interludes. The most comprehensive example of this is the opening sequence. As the camera tracks along the traffic jam in LA, the film audience takes in the real experience the drivers undergo. Then, one driver starts to get out of her car and sing. As the number develops, the camera becomes more fantastic, gathering more performers and incorporating the cars shown on set, even adding elements to the set that only fit the number, like the truck quartet. The whole scene transitions in a seemingly spontaneous fashion, integrating progressively more people. This even includes the film audience by the end of the scene. Each performer seems to be doing unique actions unified by specific choreography, in the same way each performer was introduced with unique music and each unique car unified by the shared experience of being in the same part of traffic. That is the point. What if this scene seems surreal because it is? The spontaneous beginning marking the transition from real to surreal or fantastic. The song laying out a stereotypical story of why people even come to LA to chase dreams. Integrating more characters in the shared musical narrative, even the camera movements accent the shift to the surreal with more complex movements and crane shots. All of these elements create a spectacle that brings the audience into the experience of the film and suspends belief to organically understand the meanings of the scene. These elements can also be seen in other interludes. The number Someone in the Crowd shows off the myth of integration very strongly. The beginning of the song starts with a plea by Mia's roommates for Mia to come to a party. She's initially hesitant, but as the number progresses, Mia tries to be a part of the group by going to the party. This is an overt way to show the desire for integration. But it is the second half of the scene that portrays this by denying Mia her desire by showing all the other characters paired and accenting her aloneness. Just as the opening scene introduces spontaneity with camera movements and accented it with the use of mise-en-scène, this scene does the same. The difference is that the cinematography accents the use of mise-en-scène. The actress's blocking seemed to push the camera to move only to keep the performers in frame. As Mia rushes into the bathroom at the party, the tempo of movement breathes, and she exits, the setting has added a spontaneous snowfall. As the camera movement speeds up, it gives the impression that the movement is speeding up to capture the blocking and action of the performers, which is also sped up. This marks more of a shift to spectacle and a feel that the audience can be a part of the excitement. The audience play is best exemplified by the final scene. Epilogue starts with Mia and her husband showing up to Seb's jazz club. As Seb becomes more aware she's there, he decides to play a tune for her, reprising their musical theme. This number is particularly unique in that it is solely an instrumental. In the early parts of the number, the lights dim and both characters are emphasized with dolly shots to close-up, which signal a shift into the surreal. This is signaled also by a musical match back to an earlier scene where their characters meet for a second time. The rest of the montage goes on to show what could have happened if they chose to stay together. The use of expressively stylized mise-en-scène helps to remind the audience that the narrative has gone into what could have been. This shift is important to distinguish because the audience stops being a secondary participant to a primary, in that other than Mia and Zeb, the audience is the only ones to experience this inner being of what the relationship could have been. The use of vignettes and long shot helped to set the audience in a spectacle mindset, while the use of close shot show each character's possibility of success through the surreal environment. This is made possible by the use of music. As Jessica Green outlines in her work, Understanding the Score, film music communicating to and influencing the audience. Music can have many features and functions, including conveying emotion, suggesting thematic connection, and music's ability to identify and suspend reality. These traits are all integral to the art musical, regardless of era. This emphasis on emotion also shows at least a partial connection to the inner being, because emotions are almost always tied to this inner state. The key is in conveyance of emotion, either in reality or using surreal mechanics. This film has made me think, maybe all musicals contain some level of surreal narrative and inner character play.